Welcome back to BOGObiology. Today we're going to discuss some advanced tips and tricks for using the app Vittle. I get a lot of questions from viewers about how I make my videos, and so I thought I would put together a quick tutorial for you. There are five key things that this tutorial is going to cover. The first is probably the one that I get the most questions about, which is how I do my detail work. The second is how I make things appear. The third is the use of the lock screen. The fourth is selecting specific colors on the screen. And the fifth is the different apps that I use for something called app smashing. The question that I probably get most often is how I do very detailed stuff like this picture right here. I do all of my own artwork, and if you look really closely, you can see some of the little mistakes that I make. There are a few tricks that I use in order to get really good detailed work on my screencasts. First, I always use a stylus. This is the stylus that I use when I'm making my screencasts. It's an Elago stylus. It costs about 15 bucks on Amazon. And the reasons that I like it is that it's made of metal and it's got a replaceable screw-on rubber tip. And it has sides to it like a pencil, and it's got a little bit of weight to it, so it's very easy to hold for long periods of time. I find that the styluses that are too light, the ones that are just made of plastic, are a little bit too light in order to hold comfortably. I also always like to plan out my drawings, especially my diagrams, well in advance, so I know approximately where everything is going to go and how it's going to fit together on the page. Planning in advance also allows me to do stuff like color code. All of the handouts that I use are matched up with the colors in my screencasts, and the symbols that we use are consistent across both platforms. It's also really useful to draw things very big and then shrink them down so that they fit on the screen the way that you want them to. When I drew this picture of the Simpsons, I didn't draw them at the scale that you're seeing here on the screen. Instead, I either zoomed in very far, kind of like this, or I drew it very large and then used the selector tool to shrink the images down to the size that I wanted. When you zoom in really far like this, you can start to see a lot of the little mistakes in the drawings, but if you zoom out or shrink the picture down to size, you really can't see them anymore, and so it gives you a little bit more wiggle room. Finally, if necessary, you can app smash. You can use other programs to generate your artwork and then import them into Vittle, or you can pull everything into iMovie and put it together that way. There are some things that Vittle is really good at, and then there are other things that it's not so good at. And one of the things that you can't do in Vittle is draw straight lines, so I tend to app smash stuff like this chart right here from my cell cycle screencast. I drew this in a different kind of program, and then I pulled that into Vittle. We'll talk about app smashing more later on in the screencast. Okay, so next up is how I make things appear one by one on my screen, kind of like this. The first thing I always do is make sure that everything is going to fit on the screen the way that I want. Then I take my eraser tool and I erase the last thing that I want to appear on the screen, but all in one go without lifting the pen at all. So, like this. Okay, not lifting my pen, and I'm done. Then I'll move on to the second to last thing, then this one, and then the first thing that I want to appear on the screen. And it's just important that you do them in the reverse order that you want them to appear. Then I push the record button, and I can tap the undo button as many times as I need to get things to reappear on the screen. And what I find really useful about this is that it's sometimes hard to talk and write at the same time, and so I can use this to pre-write stuff and then have it pop up on the screen as I'm talking. Next, we're going to talk about the lock screen feature. When you use the lock button feature, you can zoom in on the screen without your viewer seeing it, and it's also a great way to plan for screen dimensions. Vittle has two options, widescreen and normal screen. But the problem that I ran into when I first started making screencasting videos is that the screen size for the iPad and the screen size that YouTube likes you to use are not necessarily the same. So originally I tried using just the widescreen feature, but I wound up with sort of this funny setup where I would have some work that would appear off-center and I might see other stuff in the margins, and you can definitely see some of this in my earlier videos. So then I thought I'd solve the problem by simply using the normal screen, and then when I went on to YouTube I actually had great centered text, but I also had these funny black bars that appeared on the side of the screen, which you can also see in some of my earlier videos. So I eventually came up with a workaround where I would use the lock screen and then zoom out, and then it allowed me to anticipate the placement of objects on the screen so I wouldn't wind up with stuff either in the margins or off-center. This is what my screen looked like to record that last segment. So you can see that I used the lock screen and then zoomed outward so I could make sure that everything would be pretty much in the center. All right, now we're going to move on to selecting colors. So if you select a drawing that has multiple colors in it, you actually now get a drop-down menu on the left-hand side of your screen, and you can tap any of the colors that you want to isolate, and then you can move or delete them or shrink them or expand them however much you want. This is actually a new feature that just arrived with the last version of Vittle. Finally, last but not least, we have app smashing. So app smashing is when you use different apps and put them together in a way that they weren't necessarily designed to do. The two iPad apps that I find myself using the most often in conjunction with Vittle are Notability and Art Studio. So I use Notability for stuff like notes from class, and so I might directly select some of those and then import them straight into a screencast in order to allow for continuity between class notes and screencasts. And then Art Studio is something that I use sometimes if I'm trying to get really straight lines or make a grid or do something other than freehand drawing. It's got really great features. Okay, that pretty much wraps it up. Thanks for watching, everyone, and don't forget to subscribe.